Zoophily. Zoo means all insects, animals, everything just comes under the zoo. So insects, animals, everything involved in pollination. So based upon what animal involved in pollination, they again classify into different types. The first one is that ornithophily. Ornitho means birds. Birds also helpful in pollination. Yes, there are many birds are helpful in pollination. So what are the unique characteristics? So these flowers which possess in order to attract these birds. The first one is that the flower should be bigger in size. Yes, students, the flower should be bigger in size so that the birds can just go inside in order to capture the nectar. The birds will just be focusing in eating the nectar. At the same time, the pollen grain will be liberating or shedding on the surface of the birds. So in order to do this, the flower should be bigger in size. And also the shape of the corolla, you can just see here, it's almost cup-like or bell-like shape. Why? Because if it's very big, broad, they just goes undisturbedly, goes take nectar and go away. The main motto of this bird, of this flower, is to transfer this pollen grains from one flower to another. So in order to do that, the bird just put it head inside. The pollen grain should be formed on the surface of the head. So that's the important characteristic. So in order to do that, the flower should be bigger in size, and also the corolla should have this cup shape, bell shape cavity. And third point is that the flower should be brightly colored. Yes, if it is not colored, the bird will not get attracted. And also they should just process lots of nectar at the bottom. So this nectar should be a huge number of nectar, then only just birds come and visit the flower frequently. And very importantly, these birds are very big birds. They just fly in the air. In order to withstand that, the flower should be very strong. The flower should be tough and leathery. If not, the flower will just be spoiled. Fertilization will not take place. So these are the various characteristics of ornithophily flowers. Then the next is Cheiroptrophily. What is Cheiroptrophily? As you can rightly see in this picture, bats also helpful in pollination like birds. But bats, do the bats active in day or night? They active in night. So obviously this flower no need of color. Instead of the color, what they just wanted, they want scent, odor. The smell should be even more appealing so that the bat can just fly and come towards this flowers. So the only unique characteristic of this flower. What are the flowers which completely depend on bat for pollination is that Caesaralia africana and Adansonia digitata. So these are the two plants which completely depend on bats for pollination. Then next example in zoophily is Malacophily. As you can rightly see in this picture, snail. Yes, snail also helpful in pollination. They also come in search of nectar. As a result of getting the nectar, they just helpful in pollination. The example for this flower is plant is Limna. The next is entomophily. It's a famous interesting object. What is entomophily? Insects which are helpful in pollination. Common insect what we know is bees, all those things, but all the insects are also helpful in pollination. Among that, the very important insect what we just required is ants. Unique feature. When the ants involve in fertilization, that is called as myrmecophily. When the ants involve in pollination, that alone is called as myrmecophily. All the other insects all come to the entomophily. So what are the characteristic for these flowers? What are the various characteristic is that the flowers should be generally larger, or in case the flowers are smaller, they should be present huge bunch. That is means inflorescence, so that these insects get huge in amount of nectar. And also the flowers should be brightly colored in order to attract these insects. Along with the color, they should also produce some good scent, odor, and also nectar should be present in huge quantity. And where the nectar should be present, the nectar should be present inside the cell. Those cells are called juicy cell. So whenever this insect goes inside and pierce this cell, the nectar should just ooze out. So in that condition, this insect goes completely inside the flower. When the insect goes completely inside the flower, whatever pollen grain they just have in the body, they just goes and deposit inside the flower, which helpful in successful cross-pollination. So these are the characteristics of this entomophily. The next example for this entomophily is salvia. The salvia flower exhibit lever mechanism. Lever mechanism in the sense, bottom you have got one corolla pod and the top you have got another corolla pod. When the insect comes and sits on this bottom base, landing side, automatically what will happen, the top region just comes and bends down. So it just go deposit the whatever pollen grains it have and also gets whatever pollen grains it has from the body. And another unique feature of this flower, salvia flower, is this protoandrous. What is called protoandrous? Andrusium matures first, then ahead of gynoecium. So both the essential organs will not be matured at the same time. So if an insect visiting a flower, the insect can either get pollen grain from the flower, or if not, they can give pollen grain to that particular flower. Both cannot take place in the same plant. So that is what about salvia. So this is how the insects goes inside the salvia plant. When they just come and sit on the landing side, this gynoecium just comfortably can just, when they just keep on moving, this flowers also keep on just moving. So just comes and hit at the back of this insect. Then next, they also got various mechanism in order to trap this insects. So what are the various trap mechanism is that? First one itself is called trap mechanism. Okay, the example is Aristococcia. So automatically the corolla, when the insect just goes and falls in town, they just eat the nectar and automatically just circles at least 2 or 3 times. The result of circling, they just get the pollen grains or fertilize the flower, then annually they just comes out. Then next is pitfall mechanism. When they just comes and sits at the corner, they just automatically fall down. When they just fall down, they just get the pollen grains from the flower, or if not, they just fertilize the flower. Example is arum. Third type is clip or translator mechanism. This we already saw in our previous classes. When the insect just comes and sits out here, the clip, that Y-shaped translator, attach itself to the legs of this flower, legs of the insects, and they just carry it along with the insect wherever they just go. And the last one is piston mechanism, where the corollas are arranged in such a manner, that's a puzzle, complete puzzle. When the insects are goes in one direction, they just come out in the other direction. So until then, they'll be just trapped inside. So when they just move here and there, just rotating, they just fertilize a particular flower. Examples, papilionaceous. These both the flowers are common in our native place. So these are the various mechanisms or various agents helpful in pollination. Thank you.